He starred with Art Nicole in Being the Ricardos, playing Desi Arnaz with ease, but it took Javier Bardem years to win the role. He chats to our CBS colleague Michelle Miller about paying tributes to legends and the Oscar nominations for him and his wife, Penelope Cruz.
It's your season.
It is. And it's very overwhelming, to say the least. Yes.
You're overwhelmed.
I'm always overwhelmed by the love.
Javier Bardem is feeling a lot of love these days.
They call me Cuban Pete. I'm the king of the rumba beat.
In the spotlight,
Maracas, I go chick, chicky, boom, chick, chicky, boom.
For his portrayal of Desi Arnaz in Aaron Sorkin's Being the Ricardos.
Why is this so hard to understand?
Both he and co-star Nicole Kidman earned Screen Actors Guild and Oscar nods for their roles. Bardem isn't too proud to say he fought for it.
I was very, very immediately connected to them as a couple, to them as entertainers, and what they represented for so many people. And then I chased the role. I was like, I want to play that. And it took a good, I would say, 5 years.
You chased this for 5 years?
I chased this for 5 years, yeah.
Well, what did you have to do, Javier?
What did I have to do?
Yeah, what did you have to do to win?
Make a lot of phone calls, bother a lot of people, ask my agent to really send lots of flowers.
Guess who it is?
The characters of Lucy and Ricky Ricardo are beloved by generations for their brilliant comedy. But as a couple, they also made their mark behind the scenes in boardrooms and studios of 1950s Hollywood.
Lucy Ricardo will be pregnant on the show. An 8-episode arc, starting with Lucy telling Ricky the happy news and ending with the birth of the baby.
No.
You can't have a pregnant woman on television.
Why not?
Because it's television.
The timing of what happened with Lucy and Desi in the 1950s and having to break through so many taboos.
Absolutely. They were revolutionary. They really changed the panorama, the landscape of how to create TV comedies. And they were the first couple to run a company, a production company, being a woman and a foreigner in the 60s in the States, which is pretty amazing.
And at a time when Lucille Ball's questionable ties to the Communist Party made headlines.
Grandpa Fred was wrong, Lucy. Yes, he didn't tell you the part where they throw your father in prison for the crime of being the mayor of a city. I was chased to this country, Lucy. Believe me, you checked the wrong box.
Can you imagine what it was like for both of them?
They were very strong personalities, for sure, that really made those characters iconic. And how they achieved that is by fighting against the odds of racial, sexism, and political. And there were lots of them at the time, and there's unfortunately lots of them today.
Bardem was born with acting in his DNA. His mother, Pilar, was an award-winning actress in Spain.
So, 5 years old? She put that acting bug in you?
Exactly. Yeah, she told me to go to a set because the kid who was playing the role got sick. And she got me there and said, "What, do you want to do it?" I said, "Okay." Because that means one day with no school. So I said, "Yeah, I'll go there." ¿Cómo te llamas?
Víctor. Víctor Plata.
Víctor.
He went there, becoming a movie star in his native land.
When you're on a path here in Hollywood, sometimes folks are tight cast. How did you break through that?
It happens in Spain as well.
Does
when
it?
I started, I was 20 years old and I was playing this macho, young body type kind of guy because I was that guy as well. Believe it or not, I was that guy.
You still are. You still got it, Javier.
I'm not good at being that. And I stopped for a good couple of years because after being given this kind of roles for 2-3 movies, I stopped.
But in 2000 came the role of Reinaldo Arenas in Before Night Falls, which earned him his first Oscar nomination.
You are recognized certainly both in Spain and here in America. What does that mean to you?
I guess I feel absolutely blessed and lucky to be able to make a living out of my passion. I never planned to have a career out of Spain. It happened. And that's an amazing accident.
Accident or not, that led to an Oscar win in 2008 for his chilling performance as a sociopathic killer in No Country for Old Men.
Well, this is a necessity of yours, where I'm from. Friendo.
His range is wide. In 2018, he took on the role of Colombian drug lord Pablo Escobar.
Only 1,000 million pesos. Only. They're insulting us.
You've taken roles that are stories of real people. Mm-hmm. Does that make it more of a challenge?
It's a different monster because, in a way, people can calibrate how close you got to those people. In the case of Desi, he meant so much love and laughter to so many people, and especially his family, that you really want to work very, very thoroughly on the details to at least make sure that they understand that you tried, that you really approach it with a lot of respect and hard work.
Bardem knows a little something about being part of a celebrated couple himself. His wife, Penelope Cruz, is one of this year's Oscar nominees. She's up against his co-star, Nicole Kidman, in the Best Actress category.
To be recognized for an Oscar, it's always an honor, but to be recognized along with your own partner, it's something very unique.
It takes some of the pressure off, I would expect.
Oh, no pressure at all. I mean, I guess the older you get, you understand the beauty in it, and you really appreciate more what it means.
Yeah, but it doesn't hurt that you guys both each have your own Oscars sitting at home.
No, it doesn't hurt. I mean, if to tell you the truth, if I have to choose, I will pick her Oscar. That will make me happy.